Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1723, Unit Conversions by Cross Multiplying and Canceling Units. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I used to really love math class, and over the years, I've run into various math techniques that sometimes don't really work out very well in Excel, including something called canceling units. So we have an original amount, you know, like 20, we make 24 sales in a week, and I want to know how many minutes does it take to make a sale. Well, when we do this, we start multiplying the 24 by various factors, and I remember from math class, I can't remember where we learned this, that the next expression, since week is here on the bottom, has to start with weeks on the top. So how many weeks per hour, and it's equal 1 divided by, so 1 week is equal to 40 hours. And then the next multiplication is, because I have hours on the bottom here, the denominator, it needs to be the numerator here. So how many hours per minute? Well, that's equal 1 divided by 60. And when I multiply 24 times 0.025 times 0.016667, I get 0.01 sales per minute, but that's not what I wanted. I wanted minutes per sale, so I set this up wrong. But the easy thing to do here, to flip this over, I want to see how many minutes per sale, I just take equal 1 divided by that answer. And so if I'm making 24 sales per week, then every 100 minutes, assuming a 40-hour work week, then there is a new sale. You know, let's say that someone else is only making, you know, 10 sales per week, then they're only making a sale every 240 minutes. All right, so once I get the math right, I can continue to do what if. What if someone's doing 100 sales per week? Then that means that they're making a sale every 24 minutes. And this came up today. I was interviewing realtors, and Jose Medina stopped by and took a look at our house. We're trying to sell our house in Ohio. And I don't know a lot about real estate, but Jose threw an amazing number. I mean, he's selling 238 houses per year. Isn't that just a wild number? And I was trying to do the math in my head to figure out, if he's selling 238 houses per year, how many, basically, every how many hours is he selling a house? So let's try and set this up. So we have houses per year, and I want to try and get that down to hours. So I know that I have years on the bottom here. I want years on the top. And I could use the equation editor to create this in Excel, but I'm not going to do that. I have the underline turned on here, so I'm just going to type years, which creates my numerator, and it has the fraction line. And now I'll press Alt+Enter to go to the denominator and turn off underlining with Control-U and say years and hours. So now this fraction is going to have 1 on the top, 1 year, divided by hours is going to be, let's see, 365 times 24. All right, so we get that number, and let's do the math now. So 238 houses per year times that fraction, and we come up with how many houses per hour. But that's backwards. I want to know how many hours per house, so we just do the flip, equal 1 divided by, equal 1 divided by that fraction, and it means that Jose is selling basically a house every 37 hours, which is amazing. Now, does that mean that he's going to sell my house in 37 hours? Well, no, because he has an inventory of many, many houses, but still, it's an amazing number. If any of you out there have a realtor in the family, just check that out. See if they've ever heard of anyone selling 238 houses per year. So a couple of things here, not just that Jose sells homes, but the ability to kind of create a fraction with the text and then cross-canceling like we used to do many, many years ago in school. Whatever's on the denominator here, you want to have that in the numerator. And if you wanted to actually go through and make it look like we were canceling in the formula bar, you can choose those characters and Control 5 to do the strike through. And let's see up here, Control 5 to do the strike through, and so on. Let's see. So let's just do some what if. What if someone, a typical realtor, maybe selling 25 houses a year, then they're selling one house every 350 hours. So once you get the math set up, you can do what if, plug in a different number in there, and get different answers. Kind of a fun little math project today, something going way back to maybe high school. I don't know where I actually picked this one up. Canceling units using Excel. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.